Imagine you want to build an AI assistant that can provide accurate and up-to-date information by accessing a vast knowledge base. Or perhaps you're tasked with creating an AI system that can analyze diverse data sources to generate insightful recommendations. In both scenarios, crafting a robust data pipeline is crucial. That's where Amazon Bedrock's agents comes in. This powerful tool simplifies the process of building and configuring autonomous agents in your generative AI application. In this tutorial, we'll explore how to leverage Amazon Bedrock agents to create an end-to-end data pipeline for your AI model right in the console with little code. My name is Wanjiko Kahara, and my goal is to make technology accessible to everyone, which is why in this tutorial, I'll be taking a low-code approach to help you leverage the power of Amazon Bedrock agents. Together, we'll explore how to build robust data pipelines for your AI applications, regardless of your technical background. Let's get started. Today, I'll be walking you through four steps for creating a data pipeline. 1, data ingestion with Amazon S3. 2, knowledge bases for Amazon Bedrock integration. 3, integration with agents for Amazon Bedrock. And 4, test and deploy. Before we jump in, security is job zero here at AWS, and it's important to follow best practices, so you should use the principle of least privilege when setting permissions during this tutorial. Welcome to my AWS console. Yours may look a little different, no need to be alarmed. Our journey is actually starting with Amazon's Simple Storage Solution, or Amazon S3. Let's start from the homepage of the console and navigate to S3. You can't have a data pipeline without data, so we'll be storing our data in an S3 bucket. I've uploaded sample CSV and PDF documents for us to play with today. PDFs and CSVs, multiple file types. Knowledge Bases provides pre-processing support for various file formats, which is crucial for quality data input to models. So yes, bring us your multiple file types. For these files, I simply drag and drop them from my local storage, but there are many easy ways to upload data to S3. Now we have data, let's jump to Amazon Bedrock. Bedrock is a fully managed service that offers choice of high-performing foundational models, along with a broad set of capabilities for building generative AI applications, such as agents and knowledge bases. Knowledge bases for Amazon Bedrock offers you the ability to consolidate diverse data sources into a centralized repository of information, enabling efficient access and integration for your generative AI application. Knowledge bases for Amazon Bedrock offers a fully managed end-to-end retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, simplifying tasks like data ingestion, updating, and syncing. What does RAG do? It allows AI systems to retrieve relevant information from a knowledge base and then use that information to generate more accurate and informative responses. How does that work within knowledge bases? To allow our system to effectively retrieve information from private data sources, like documents or files, we first need to break them down into smaller, more manageable pieces called chunks. This chunking process makes it easier for the system to find and access the relevant information it needs. Next, we convert these chunks into a special format called embeddings. Embeddings are like a unique digital footprint for each chunk, capturing its meaning and context. These embeddings are then stored in a searchable index, a vector database, while still maintaining a link back to the original document they came from. When someone asks a question or makes a query, the system uses these embeddings to determine which chunks of text from the data sources are most relevant and semantically similar to the query. It does this by comparing the query to the embeddings and finding the closest matches. The system then combines the user's question with the relevant chunks of text it retrieved and uses this additional context to generate a more informed and accurate response. This process of chunking, embedding, indexing, allows the AI to quickly and accurately retrieve the most pertinent information from large data sources without having to search through the entire document word for word. Now, let's set this up and get back to the demo. To get started with knowledge bases, select Create Knowledge Base. Now we have the ability to name our knowledge base and select IAM permissions. I'm choosing to let knowledge bases create a new service role for this knowledge base. Click Next. Knowledge bases directly connects with Amazon S3. So for data source, I'm going to select the S3 bucket I showed earlier with our diverse data. Currently, you can connect up to 5 sources. Select Next. Now, we select the embeddings model we want to use to convert our data. Knowledge bases will take our data, convert it into embeddings with our chosen model, and store it into a vector database of our choosing. Bedrock will also manage and update our embeddings. Talk about end-to-end workflow. Today, I'm going to choose the Titan Embeddings G1 text model by Amazon. Fun fact, this model works with over 100 languages. So whether your documents are saying hello or habari, this model may work for you. In terms of vector database to store your embeddings, we have options. Option 1, we can let Amazon create a vector store for us using Amazon OpenSearch Serverless. Currently, if you choose that option, you can only be used for development and cannot be migrated to a production workload. Option 2, if you're using a vector store that you've already created, similar to Amazon S3 integration, it will need to be set up prior to creating your knowledge base. Currently, it currently supports Amazon OpenSearch Serverless, Amazon Aurora, MongoDB, Pinecone, or Redis Enterprise Cloud. You're free to pick what makes the most sense for you. I'm going to let Amazon create one for me. The system really allows for customization, giving you as users control over chunking strategy, embeddings models, and vector stores. Now, review all our configurations and select Create. It may take a couple minutes. And congratulations! You just made a knowledge base with Amazon Bedrock. Now we have our knowledge base. Let's test it out to sync your data. I know I said no code, but I do have to mention you can test your knowledge base with the Retrieve and Generate API and the Retrieve API. The output of the Generate and Retrieve and Generate API is a generated response with source attribution and retrieved text chunks. I've linked documentation for more information how to use the APIs in the video description. Here in the console, we can test our knowledge base here on the right. Select your model. I'm choosing Claude Instant 1.2. We can even customize the search strategy of our knowledge base. Edit the prompt template or add filters. Now let's ask it a question. Notice how you can check the source details for the response directly from your data. Isn't that neat? We have uploaded our documents to S3 and created a knowledge base. Now we're ready for agents for Amazon Bedrock. What can agents do? Agents in Amazon Bedrock are like virtual assistants that can help your customers or users complete tasks and get things done more effectively. These agents can understand user requests and gather information through natural conversation and take action to fulfill the user's needs. For example, you could create an agent that helps customers process insurance claims or make travel reservations. The agent can interact with your company's systems, databases, and other resources to get the job done without you having to write complex code or managing infrastructure. Agents can also enhance their responses by retrieving relevant information from data sources, i.e. the knowledge base we just created, making it more accurate and more helpful. They can automate tasks that would typically require manual effort, saving you and your customers valuable time and effort. The best part is Amazon Bedrock handles all the behind-the-scenes work, such as managing user permissions, encryption, and invoking APIs, prompt engineering, memory, and monitoring. You can focus on defining the tasks and capabilities you want your agent to have, while Amazon Bedrock takes care of the rest. Let's start by selecting Create Agent and naming our agent. Once again, I'm going to let Bedrock create a resource for me. Notice we have a great deal of freedom in terms of configurations. Today, I'm going to choose the Amazon Titan G1 Premier model, but feel free to choose what's right for you. Currently, you can also use Claude V2 by Anthropic. I enjoy the ability to give instructions to the agent, and here, you must actually tell the agent how to perform. You can also specify tone and style if you'd like, and don't forget to press save. I'm going to add, ask the user their favorite color. You have an option for setting up either an action group or a knowledge base or both. An action group defines actions that the agent can perform for the user. For example, you could define an action group called Book Hotel that helps users carry out actions that you can define, such as create booking. Let's associate a knowledge base to the agent to augment the agent's performance. We're actually going to be selecting the knowledge base we created earlier, and we can also give this agent specific instructions on how to interact with that knowledge base. Let's open up advanced prompts. Here, we have the options to really customize our agent even further for specific use cases. Is completely optional though. But Agents for Bedrock gives you the ability easily in the console. Make sure to click save, then prepare, and now finally, let's test it. Let's try asking it a question. Look at us, we have a working agent. Once again, you can test your agent with an API, as well as the information provided in the notes. I feel fantastic about our agent, and now I'd like to deploy it in our last step. Select save and exit. Now select create alias. I'm going to name mine Ice Cream 1. Creating a new version and associating it to this alias. Lastly, you will set your application to make API calls to this agent's alias. Yay, we did it. We built an end-to-end data pipeline with Agents for Amazon Bedrock. Throughout this video, we've broken down the complexities involved in managing RAG workflows and integrating knowledge bases into generative AI applications. With this information, you can leverage the full potential of Amazon Bedrock agents on your own to build solutions, confident that Amazon Bedrock agents simplifies the complexities, enabling you to focus on delivering exceptional experiences to your users. If you've enjoyed this video and want more hands-on technical content, be sure to like this video and subscribe to the AWS Developers channel. Thanks for watching.